Hi everyone, this is Billy. This week, I thought of another way to build my passive vertical hydroponics that doesn't use electric pumps and just use gravity pool to get the nutrient from the top tank down to each basin and each layer. So this is the basin version. I thought it is easier to make and it's easier to maintain because everything is exposed to the outside. However, the challenge is how to make it stable because the central pole is quite thin. We may need to use a bigger pipe. So I made this video to show you how I turned this into something real to do a proof of concept testing. In the end, there's still a lot of improvement, but let's see. Today, I'm going to show you how I set up my proof of concept vertical hydroponic tower, which is passive. This version is the basin version. This is the latest idea I found. So you can get some of this disposable takeaway basin for food. Drill a big hole inside, 32 millimeter hole. Or if you want it to be more stable, more long lasting, use a plastic basin. You should choose the one that is opaque, not like dark or brown, so light will not come through, to avoid the growth of algae, because this tank will be full of nutrients. If the nutrient contact light, they will become algae. So again, drill a 32 millimeter hole. So let me set up this quickly, show you how this can easily be set up. So first, we use this type of standpipe and then push it in, and then on the other end there's a washer and standpipe, so just turn it, just fasten it like that, make sure it's watertight. Okay, so I'm going to finish setup for the other ones. Okay, should be quick. And then in between each basin, we have this foam board with a hose drilled. And this is the flow valve we'll put into one of the basin. Actually, every basin needs a flow valve. So this is how the foam board will be used. We have this grow basket, six of them, or you can just put in the cotton. The last step is to put in this nutrient tank, but I haven't figured out how to do it yet, so Let's stop for the time being. Let me give you the whole tower. So this is the whole tower, the basin version. Hello, I want to show you my proof of concept vertical hydroponic tower. This is a passive one. There will be a nutrient bucket at the top, like this one. And then the nutrient will flow down from the top to each tank. And in each tank, there will be a flow valve like this one inside. So this one will be inside to control the water level. To maintain the duct and the flow valve, you can just lift this foam board. So there will be a number of layers. And then the base will be secured to a board down there. This big basin is to catch any water that may accidentally flood if the flow valve fails to work. The problem is, as you can see, this is very unstable. So I think the central pipe need to be a bit bigger. This is 32 millimeter now. I think it needs to be 50 millimeter or even bigger. And then the way I connect them individually is through the standpipe. The standpipe is not firm enough, so you can easily twist and bounce. It will be better to have a central pipe that is straight and not divided into different sections, so it can stay firm. Right now it's very fragile. Okay, so my next test will be using a single central pole, which is thicker.